Welcome, everybody. Thank you so much for being with us. My name is Angie D. I'm the Director of Audience of One Productions, and we're so thankful that you all spent time to come. We've been praying over these seats to be filled, and God has blessed us immensely. So we're so thankful you're here. Let me just tell you a little bit about Audience of One. This is our second year in production, and we have a Christmas carol coming up. So the auditions are going to be at the end of August, 1st of September. And so if you are thinking of being in a Christmas show, we would love for you to come and join us. Couple of housekeeping things. We have a t-shirt and DVD and posters available at the cell. And inside your bulletin, would you guys please look at the insert? There are a couple of things. One of them is if you want to be on our mailer for future shows and future auditions, please fill out your email address. We won't bug you. We'll just send you all the information on those two things. And then the other thing is we have a list of shows that we've been suggested to do, that have been suggested to us to do, and we want to hear from you. What do you want to see Audience of One do in the future? So if you'll fill those out, and there'll be a basket back there as you're leaving, we would love to have those inputs from you. We also want to let you know that there's exits here and then two at the back. There's not an exit this way. And so, you guys, if anything comes up, that's how you get out. And another thing for your safety is please keep all of your belongings under the chairs. We are going to have dancers out on the floor and even up and down the aisles. Last year, we had people sitting in people's laps that were from the show. That won't happen this year. But we definitely are going to be very much in the audience with you at some point. So just for your safety and for the actors' safeties, please stay in your seats. Cell phones. I don't think I have to tell you guys. We want you guys to make sure that all your cell phones are turned down or off. And I think that's all the housekeeping. Now, on a personal note, I just want to just say it's been an honor and a privilege working with all these actors, dancers. My music director, Gina Pond, has done an amazing job with music. We're so thankful for her. Our choreographer, Mallory Mundy, is top of the line, Broadway level, amazing. And we just are so thankful that our team has come together. Some other people I want to mention that are unsung heroes are our sound guy, Tanner Roman, and Josh Piercy running our lights. Delaney Brandon is my stage manager, and she is absolutely amazing. My right hand, I don't even know what to call her, my assistant, my best friend, my sister-in-law, Katie D, has kept my brain together. She's been my organizer. Carrie Delphia does hair and makeup along with a whole group of girls who are amazing. And then I have my orchestration, Abby Austin, who I don't know. I'm not going to be okay when she goes to college here in the fall. I'm going to miss her like crazy. So anyway, without further ado, we would like to bring you Beauty and the Beast, a tale as old as time.
Thank you. Once upon a time, in a faraway land, a young prince lived in a shining castle. Although he had everything his heart desired, the prince was spoiled, selfish, and unkind. But then, one winter's night, an old beggar woman came to the castle and offered him a single rose in return for shelter from the bitter cold. Repulsed by her haggard appearance, the prince sneered at the gift and turned the old woman away. But she warned him not to be deceived by appearances, for beauty is found within. And when he dismissed her again, the old woman's ugliness melted away to reveal a beautiful enchantress. The prince tried to apologize, but alas, it was too late, for she had seen that there was no love in his heart. As punishment, she transformed him into a hideous beast and placed a powerful spell on the castle and all that lived there. Ashamed of his monstrous form, the beast concealed himself inside his castle with a magic mirror as his only window to the outside world. The rose she had offered was truly an enchanted rose, which would bloom for many years. If he could learn to love another and earn their love in return by the time the last petal fell, then the spell would be broken. If not, he would be doomed to remain a beast for all time. As the years passed, he fell into deep despair and lost all hope. For who could ever learn to love a beast?
Little town, it's a quiet village. Every day, like the one before. Little town, full of little people, waking up to say,
bonjour, bonjour, bonjour.
There goes the baker with his tray, like always, the same old just the same since the morning that we came to this poor provincial town.
Good morning, Belle.
Good morning, Monsieur.
Where are you off to?
Bookshop. I just finished the most wonderful story about a beanstalk and an ogre and...
That's nice. Marie, the maggots, hurry up.
Look, there she goes. That girl is strange, no question. Dazed and distracted, can't you tell? Never part of any crowd,
cause her head's up on some cloud.
They're denying she's a funny girl.
Bonjour. How is your family?
Bonjour. Good day. How is your wife?
I need 6 eggs.
There must be more than this provincial.
Ah, Belle.
Good morning. I've come to return the book I borrowed.
Finished already?
Oh, I couldn't put it down. Have you got anything new?
Not since yesterday.
It's all right. I'll borrow this one.
That one? But you've read it twice.
Oh, well, it's my favorite. Far off places, daring sword fights, magic spells, a prince in disguise.
If you like it all that much, it's yours.
But, sir...
I insist.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much.
Look, there she goes, that girl is so peculiar. I wonder if she's feeling well.
With a dreamy, far-off look,
and her nose stuck in a book.
What a puzzle to the rest of us is
Belle. Oh, isn't this amazing? It's my favorite part, because you'll see. She meets Prince John. number three.
Now it's no wonder that her name means beauty. Her looks have got no parallel.
But behind her fair facade, I'm afraid she's rather odd.
Very different from the rest of us.
She's nothing like the rest of us. She's different from the rest of us.
You're the greatest hunter in the whole world!
I know!
No beast alive stands a chance against you, and no girl for that matter!
It's true, Boo! And I've got my sights set on that!
The inventor's daughter!
She's the one! The lucky girl I'm going to marry!
But she's...
the most beautiful girl in town!
I know, but...
that makes her the best! Don't I deserve the best?
Oh, of course you do!
Right from the moment when I met her, saw her, I said she's gorgeous and I fell. Here in town there's only she who's as beautiful as me, so I'm making plans to woo and marry Belle. Let me do pictures.
Well, some people use their imagination.
You know, Belle, it's about time you got your head out of these books and started paying attention to more important things.
Hint, hint.
Like you.
Exactly. The whole town is talking about it. It's not right for a woman to read. As soon as she starts getting ideas and thinking.
Gaston, you are positively primeval.
Oh, why, thank you, Belle. What do you say you and I take a walk down to the tavern and look at my old trophies?
What do you say we don't?
Come on, Belle. I think I know your feelings for me.
You can't even imagine. Now, Gaston, please, I have to get home to help my father.
That crazy old fool. He needs all the help he can get.
Don't talk about my father that way.
Yeah, don't talk about her father that way.
My father's not crazy. He's a genius. Oh, Papa.
Some genius.
What's a genius?
Now the fool. I want you to go into the woods and bring back the biggest, healthiest deer you can find.
Not the woods! Anything but the woods, Gaston! You know I hate the woods!
Just bring me a deer for my wedding feast!
But Gaston, I hate the woods! It's dark, and it's spooky, and there's bugs, and there's spiders!
Papa, are you all right?
I'm fine. But I can't, for the life of me, figure out why that happened! This isn't the stubbornest piece of... ow!
Papa!
I'm about ready to give up on this hunk of junk.
You always say that.
I mean it this time. I'll never get this boneheaded contraption to work.
Yes, you will. And you'll win first prize at the fair tomorrow. And become a world-famous inventor.
You really think so?
You know I do. I always have.
Well, we better get cracking. This thing ain't gonna fix itself. Now let's see. Where did I put that dog-legged clincher?
Papa.
So tell me, did you have a good time in town?
I got a new book.
You do love those books.
Well, they take me away to wonderful places where there's adventure, mystery, romance, and happy endings. Papa, if I ask you something, will you answer me honestly?
Don't I always?
Do you think I'm odd?
My daughter, odd? Now where'd you get an idea like that?
Oh, I don't know, it's just that, well, people talk.
They talk about me too? No, I'm not odd nor you, no family ever saner, except one uncle who will maybe let that pass. In all you say or do, you couldn't make it plainer. You are your mother's daughter, therefore you are class.
So I should just accept I'm simply not like them.
They are the common herd, and you can take my word. You are unique, creme de la creme. No matter what you do, I'm on your side. And if my point of view is somewhat misty, there's nothing clearer in my life than what I wish and feel for you. And that's a lot, no matter what.
No matter what they say, you make me proud. I love the funny way you stand out from the crowd.
It's my intention, my invention shows the world out there one day just what we've got, no matter what. Now some may say all fathers just exaggerate,
that every daughter's great.
You are.
Every daughter tends to say her father's tops.
She pulls out all the stops to praise him,
and quite rightly.
No matter what the pain, we've come this far. I pray that you remain exactly as you are. This really is a case of father knowing best,
and daughter too.
You're never strange.
Don't ever change.
You're all I've got, no matter. What?
Now, what do you say we give her a try?
All right.
Come over here. Stand right there. Here we go.
It works!
It does? It does!
Papa, you did it! You really did it! You won first prize at the fair tomorrow, I know it!
Who knows? Maybe I will at that.
Oh, I almost forgot. I made you a scarf for good luck at the fair tomorrow.
Now I'll know I'll win. And then we'll get out of this town and travel to all those places you've read about in your books. Well, I'm off.
Goodbye, Papa.
Bye-bye, Belle.
Be careful.
First prize is nearly mine. It's quite my best invention. So simple yet complex, so massive yet so small. This triumph of design will be my old age pension. That is, providing I can find the fair at all. I must have missed a sign. I should have paid attention. Drat! That's not a nightingale, and not a mating call. Wolves!
Thank you. Well, now you've done it. I told you not to let him in.
I could not leave him for the wolves.
He could have. It would have been better if he didn't.
Is someone here?
If we keep quiet, maybe he'll go away.
Is someone home?
Not a word, Lumiere. Not one word.
I don't mean to intrude. It's just I lost my way in the woods, and I need a place to stay for the night.
Oh, Cogsworth, have a heart. Monsieur, you are welcome here.
I heard that. I know there's someone here, and I thank you to step out where I can see you.
Hello!
And goodbye. Come.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. I'm a clock? You're a clock!
Yes, astonishing, isn't it? And quite inexplicable. Goodbye.
Cogsworth, I'm surprised at you. Where are your manners?
We've got to get him out of here before the master finds out.
This is incredible. How is this accomplished?
Really, sir, it's not really that big of a... Ow! Yes, no. Really, sir, do you mind?
Well, I'm stumped. Maybe. It's a newfangled scientific gadget!
Ha! Oh, I, sir, am not a gadget.
I beg your pardon. I don't mean to be rude. It's just I've never seen a talking... Achoo!
Bless you.
Oh, monsieur. You are chilled to the bone. Come, let us warm you by the fire.
No, I forbid it. Lumiere is head of this household. I demand you stop right there. Wait, what are you doing? Not in the master's chair. I'm not seeing this.
Na-na, what do we have here? Do my eyes deceive me, or is this a man? It's been so long since I've seen a real man. No offense, Lumiere. Oh. Bonjour, monsieur. Mind if I sit here?
Well, hello.
All right, this has gone far enough. I am in charge here, and
coming
I said
the room. Would you like a nice spot of tea, sir? It'll warm you up in no time.
Oh, yes, please.
No! No tea. He'll be here all night. No tea.
There you are.
This is just what I...
I think I scared him, Mama.
Well, hello there, little fella. What's your name?
Chip.
Figures.
Care for a blanket, monsieur? I just love older men.
Of course you do, Babbitt. You are always trying to make me jealous. But it will not work this time.
Me? What about you? With Simon?
Jacques?
Michel?
Pierre?
Veronique?
Ooh, Veronique.
Lumiere, listen to me. We've got to get him out of here. Do you have any idea what the master will do? Finds out that we let it straight
to the castle. The master will never have to know. As I was saying, it's about the final roulette, and it's your fault.
Should we hide, Mama?
Of course not. There's absolutely no reason to panic.
Lumiere's right. There's absolutely no reason to panic. May I borrow this?
Oh, thank you. There's a stranger here!
Hey, Master, allow me to explain. The gentleman
who let him in?
Master, may I take this opportunity to say I was against it from the start?
Who dared to disobey me?
Oh, dear!
You have all betrayed me! Who are you?
Maurice?
What are you doing in my castle?
I lost my way in the woods.
You're not welcome here.
I'm sorry. I'll just be on my way.
It's hideous, isn't it?
No, I wasn't.
You come to stare at the beast.
No.
Haven't you?
No. I'm merely looking for a place to stay.
I'll give you a place to stay.
Go and do something
getting married. Don't let a little thing like that change your feelings for me.
Oh, no.
No, never.
And we'll still have our little rendezvouses, won't we?
Oh, yes.
Ooh. Yes, always.
Good. Well, if there's going to be a wedding, I'd better go propose to the bride. Run along now. Belle! Oh, Belle! Anyone home? Oh, hello.
Gaston, what a pleasant surprise.
Oh, isn't it, though? I'm just full of surprises. For you, mademoiselle.
A miniature portrait of you. I got it! I got it! I got it! Gaston, you shouldn't have.
Oh, don't mention it. You know, Belle, there isn't a girl in town who wouldn't love to be in your shoes. This is the day your dreams come true.
What could you possibly know about my dreams, Gaston?
Oh, plenty. You've been dreaming just one dream nearly all your life. Hoping, scheming, just one theme. Will you be a wife? Will you be some he-man's property? Good news, that he-man's me. This equation, girl plus man, doesn't help just you. On occasion, women can have their uses too. Mainly to extend the family tree. Pumpkin, extend with me. Raising sons galore.
Inconceivable.
Each built 6'4".
Unbelievable.
Each one stuffed with every guest on need.
I'm not hearing this.
You'll be keeping house with pride.
So incredible.
Each day gratified.
So unwettable.
That you are part of this idyllic scene. Now picture this. A rustic hunting lodge. My latest kill roasting over the fire. My little wife massaging my feet while the little ones play on floor with the dogs. Oh, we'll have 6 or 7.
Dogs?
No, Belle, strapping boys like me.
Imagine that.
I can see that we will share all that love implies. We shall be the perfect pair, rather like my thighs. You are face to face with destiny. All roads lead to the best things in life, for all's well that ends with me. Escape me, there's no way, certain as Dore. Belle, when you marry. So, Belle, what'll it be? Is it yes or is it? Oh, yes.
I just don't deserve you.
Who does? Me!
But thanks for asking.
$999,000
So, how'd it go?
Oh, you know that Belle. She's always playing hard to get.
She turned you down?
For now. But I will have Belle for my wife. Make no mistake about that.
Wait. If she turned him down, then I still have a chance. Get out of my way!
Oh, stop it!
He's mine!
Is he gone? Can you imagine? He asked me to marry him. Me, the wife of that boorish brainless. Madame Gaston, can't you just see it? Madame Gaston, his little wife. No, sir, not me. I guarantee it. I want much more than this provincial life. understand. I want so much more than they've got planned.
Oh, Belle, Belle, have you seen Gaston?
You just missed him.
Okay.
Wait, where did you get that scarf?
In the woods. Pretty nice, huh?
This belongs to my father.
Well, finders keepers.
Wait, LeFou, I need you to think hard and tell me exactly where you found this.
No!
Think! Think? Come on.
Somewhere in the woods,
Carter? Come on.
Near the crossroads, ow!
Then he must still be out there somewhere. You have to take me back.
Not the woods again!
Can't you see? Something must have happened to him. You have to take me back.
Not of your life!
Fine. Then I'll find him myself.
It wasn't your idea. If we took it collectively,
well,
you wouldn't be perfect.
Yes, of course.
Okay?
But yeah, you couldn't keep your little waxy mouth shut, and you had to say, "Oh, I have an idea. We'll serve him tea. We'll sit in the master's chair."
Is that really how I said? I was trying to be hospitable.
Rubbish.
Cogsworth, can you blame me for trying to save what's left of our humanity?
Yes.
Look at us. Look at you.
What about me?
Where? You're always insufferable, but if I know you become a little bit more inflexible, a little bit more tightly wound, a little bit more, this is a dozy, ticked off.
Please spare me your stupid puns.
I'll save some more for at least we're not as far as gone as some of the others. You saw what happened to Michelle.
She was always too vain about her looks, and that is exactly what she's become.
A vanity.
Little drawers and a mirror, the works.
And you remember Jean-Claude?
Who?
Jean-Claude. Not too bright. Dumb
a brick.
The entire wall.
Jean-Claude is a brick wall?
Yes, that's him in the kitchen, behind the stove. Oh, hello, bonjour. And what, Guillaume? He was the houseboy.
The houseboy, or that mealy-mouthed little bootlicker. I never liked him. He was always groveling at the master's feet.
Cogsworth?
Yes?
He's the doormat.
Perfect!
It's happening faster with some of the others, but we are not far behind. Slowly, but surely, as each day passes, we will become, well, things.
But why did we have to get dragged into this whole spell business? It's not like we threw the poor old beggar woman out on her ear.
True, but are we not too responsible for making the master the way that he is?
I suppose so.
All I know is that eventually I will melt away into nothing. I only pray that there is something left of me, even a little. If the master ever breaks this spell.
Hold on, old man. We've got to hold on.
Hello? Is anyone here? Hello?
It's a girl.
Yes, I can see it's a girl.
it's a girl! Mademoiselle!
Lumiere, let me do most of the talking.
Yahoo!
Let's not be hasty.
Sherry!
A word, just a word. That's all I'm asking for.
Mama, you're not going to believe what I saw. Not in a million thousand years. Not in a million trillion thousand years.
Yes, dear?
No, seriously. It's a thing that everybody's been waiting for since... since I don't know when.
All right, Chip, what is it?
There's a girl in the castle.
Bless my soul, wouldn't that just be lovely?
But there is, I saw her.
Now, Chip, I will not have you making up wild stories, getting everyone's hopes up for no reason. Mrs. Potts, did you hear? There is a girl in the castle!
See? I told you. And she's really pretty, too.
Well, I don't know about that.
This is the one! This is the girl we've been waiting for! She's come to break the spell! 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 Isn't it wonderful? After all these years! Oh, happy day!
Oh, my goodness!
We should tell the others, no.
Yes?
No! No! Wait a minute! Wait a minute!
Hello? Is anyone here? Please, I'm looking for my father.
Belle?
Papa?
Is that you? How did you find me?
Your hands are like ice. We have to get you out of here.
Belle, you must leave this place.
Who's done this to you?
There's no time to explain. You must go. Now!
I won't leave you here. Who's there? I know someone's there. Who are you?
The master of this castle.
Then you're the one who's responsible for this. Release my father at once.
I don't take orders from anyone. Throw her out.
No. No. No, wait. Wait, please. Please, can't you see he's not well?
Then he should not have trespassed here.
But he's an old man. He could die.
He came into my house uninvited, and now he will suffer the consequences.
Please, I'll do anything.
No.
There is nothing you can do.
Please!
I said there is nothing you can do!
Take me instead!
No!
What did you say?
Take me instead!
You would do that? You would take his place?
If I did, would you let him go?
Yes. But you must promise to stay here. Forever.
No!
Forever?
Forever! Or he dies in the dungeon!
That's not fair! Come into the light.
Make your choice.
Belle, listen to me. I'm old. I've lived my life.
You have my word.
Done!
Papa.
No!
Papa!
Belle!
No!
Please, I'm begging you. Let her go!
No!
No! No! Belle!
Not yet!
Belle!
Not yet!
Master. Master, please. It seems as if the girl is going to be staying with us for, well, quite some time. You may want to offer her a more comfortable room.
You didn't let me say goodbye.
What?
I'll never see him again. And you didn't even let me say goodbye.
I'll show you to your room.
My room? But I thought...
Do you want to stay in that dungeon?
No!
Then follow. You follow me. This is your home now. You are free. To go anywhere you like. But there is one place that you cannot go. And that is the West Wing.
Why? What's in the West?
It's forbidden. You are never to set foot in there. Do you understand?
Yes.
Do you understand?
Yes.
If you need anything, my servants... They will attend you. And one more thing. You will join me for dinner. That is not a request.
Mm. Yes, I made the choice. For Papa, I will stay. But I don't deserve to lose my freedom in this way, you monster. If you think that what you've done is right, well then, you're a fool. Think again. Is this home? Is this where I should learn to be happy? Never dreamed that a home could be dark and cold. Every day in my childhood, even as we grow old, home should be where the heart is. Never were words so true. My heart's far, far away. Home is too. What I give that I knew lately, and to think I complained of that dull provincial town. Is this home? Am I here for a day or forever? Shut away from the world until who knows when.
Dear, I thought you might like some tea.
Come in.
Nothing like a nice warm cup of tea to make the world seem a bit brighter now.
But you're
Mrs. Potts, dear, very pleased to make your acquaintance.
Careful, darling.
Who are you?
Madame de la Grande.
Boosh, perhaps you've heard of me.
No, sorry.
You see? They've forgotten all about me. One can be, and I quote, the toast of Europe, the brightest star ever to grace the stage. But fall under one little spell and
Wait, this is impossible.
I know it is, but here we are. Well now, what shall we dress you in for dinner? This is nice, but how would you like to borrow one of my gowns? Let's see what I've got in my drawers. How embarrassing! Ah, here we are. I wore this the night I performed at the Royal Opera. The king himself was there. Of course, I wouldn't have a prayer of fitting into it now. Take it.
That's very kind of you, but I'm not going to dinner.
Be silly, of course you're going to dinner. You heard what the master said.
He may be your master, but he's not mine. I'm sorry. This is all just happening so fast.
Well, that was a very brave thing you did, my dear.
We all think so.
I'm going to miss my papa so much. Well, cheer up, child.
may seem bleak right now, but you mustn't despair. We're here to see you through. I hope that we'll be friends, though I don't know you well. If anyone can make the most of living here, then Bill, it's you.
Tangled with the wrong man!
Darn right!
No one says no to Gaston! Dismissed! Rejected! Publicly humiliated! It's more than I can bear!
More beer!
What for? Nothing helps! I'm disgraced!
Who, you? Never, Gaston! You gotta pull yourself together! Gosh, it disturbs me to see you, Gaston, looking so down in the dumps. Ha! Every guy here loves to be you, Gaston, even when taking your lumps. There's no man in town as admired as you. You're everyone's favorite guy. Everyone's awed and inspired by you. And it's not very hard to see why. No one's slick as Gaston. No one's quick as Gaston. No one's neck as incredibly thick as Gaston. There's no man in town half as manly. Perfect, a pure paragon. You can ask any Tom, Dick, or Stanley, and they'll tell you whose team they prefer to be on. No one's
thin like Gaston, a kingpin like Gaston.
Specimen, yes, I'm in Timothy.
My, what a guy that Gaston. Goodbye, arise, well, hip hip.
Gaston is the best, and the rest is all drips.
No one likes like Gaston, else is likes like Gaston.
In a wrestling match, nobody fights like Gaston.
As you see, I've got biceps to spare.
Not a bit in the scraggly or scrawny.
That's right. And every last inch of me's covered with hair.
No one hits like Gaston, matches with like Gaston.
In a spinning match, nobody spits like Gaston.
I'm especially good at expectorating toys.
For Gaston.
When I was a lad, I ate 4 dozen eggs every day to help me get large. Now that I'm grown, I eat 5 dozen eggs, so I'm roughly the size of a barge.
Let's go!
by decorating.
My, what a guy!
What a guy!
Gaston!
Hey!
Wow!
Drinks on the food!
Yeah!
Please, help me! He's got her! He's got her locked up in a dungeon! Belle! Oh, we must go at once! Not a minute to lose!
Whoa, whoa, slow down, old man! Who's got Belle locked in a dungeon?
A beast! A hideous beast!
Is it a big beast?
Huge!
Spooky old eyes!
Yes, yes!
Ugly snout!
Hideously!
And sharp, cruel fangs!
Yes! Will you help me? Please, will you help me?
All right, old man, we'll help you. Out!
What are you doing? Fine!
Bye-bye.
I'll go back there and get her myself!
Bye, old man!
Crazy old Maurice.
He's always good for a laugh!
Bye, fellas!
Crazy old Maurice! Crazy old Maurice!
A dangerous pastime!
I know, but that wacky old coot is Belle's father. Sanity's only so-so. Now the wheels in my head have been turning since I looked at that loony old man. See, I promised myself I'd be married to Belle. Right now I'm evolving a plan. If I...
Yes?
Then we...
No, would she? Guess how I get it. Let's go! No one flops like Gaston.
Takes deep shots like Gaston.
Lance the person you harmless crackpots like Gaston.
Yes, I'm endlessly wildly resourceful.
As down through the depths you descend,
I won't even be mildly remorseful.
Just as long as you get what you want in the end.
Who has brains like Gaston?
Entertains like Gaston. Can make up these endless refrains like Gaston. And his marriage we soon will be celebrating. My, what a guy, Gaston.
Well, what is it?
Is dinner ready, Mrs. Potts?
Just about. I haven't the foggiest idea what she likes to eat, so I cooked up everything in the kitchen.
Good, good. Well, don't just stand there gaping. Get back to work.
You tell him.
I can't.
Tell me what?
Go.
Just like a woman. Well, don't freak out, but there is something on your back.
What are you talking about?
What's that?
It appears to be a welding handle of sorts.
Well, then, get it off!
Okay, just...
Get it off!
One, two, three!
Not
the way.
Twist.
Un,
pull it
two,
off.
It won't come off.
What do you mean it won't come off? Where did it come from? It wasn't there when I went to bed last night. Why is this happening to me?
It's the spell, I'm afraid.
Just try to relax.
Relax?
Oui.
Relax. How can I relax with this appendage on my back? Is there no dignity left in me? What's going to go next, my mind?
Just try to calm down.
I'm frightened, Lumiere.
I know. But you're not alone.
We are all in this together.
It's time for dinner. Where is she?
I'll check on her, but be a moment.
I told her to come down. What's taking so long?
Try to be patient, sir. The girl has lost her father and her freedom all in one day.
Hey, master.
Have you perhaps thought this girl could, be the one to break the spell?
Of course I have. I'm not a fool.
Good. Then you fall in love with her, and she falls in love with you, and voila! The spell will be broken. We'll be human again by midnight.
Lumiere, it's not that easy. These things, they do take time.
This time, which you're speaking of, we do not have. The rose has already begun to wilt.
It's no use. She is so beautiful, and I'm... Well, look at me!
Here's a point.
Master, you must help her to see past all that.
I don't know how.
Well, you can start by trying to make yourself look more presentable. Straighten up. Try and act like a gentleman.
Impress her with your rapier wit.
But be gentle.
Shower her with compliments.
But be sincere.
And above all...
What?
You must control your temper.
Well?
What?
Where is she?
Who? Oh, the girl. Well, actually, she's in the process... circumstances being what they are.
She's not coming. She's not coming.
What did you say?
She's not coming.
We'll see about that!
Your Lordship, your Grace, let's not be hasty.
Everyone, Lumiere, stand aside. I thought I told you to come down to dinner.
I'm not hungry.
I'm the master of this castle, and I'm telling you to come down to dinner.
And I'm telling you that I'm not hungry.
You're hungry when I say you're hungry.
Don't be ridiculous.
What did you say?
You can't just go around ordering people to be hungry. It doesn't work like
that. I can't too.
Besides, it's rude.
Rude, is it? Well, how about this? If you don't come down to dinner, I'll drag you by the hair.
Please, attempt to be a gentleman.
But why is she being so difficult? Why are you being so difficult?
Why are you being such a bully?
Because I want you to come down to dinner with me.
So you admit you're being a bully? Until I hear the sound of my voice laughter as he runs through these halls again.
quite right, Mrs. Potts. We mustn't give up while there is still a chance. Come here. Come here, now. Come. You stand guard at that door, and if there's the slightest change, you inform me at once. We won't, Captain. I asked nicely, but she refuses. What? What does she want me to do? Beg? Show me the girl. And in that which was gone, and left me in this state, an object of revulsion and derision, hated. Is there no one who can show me how to win the world's forgiveness? Now what did they say? Show her the cards. Impress her with your wit.
Glass of water for us to bring.
I'm surprised at you!
is not a prisoner here,
but she is our guest.
We must make her feel welcome here.
Okay, dinner, but you keep it down. If the master finds out, it will be our next.
Of course.
Of course. But what is dinner without a little music?
Music?
Ma chère mademoiselle, it is the deepest one. It lights us better.
It's so
lovely tonight. Now we invite you to relax. Let us pull up a chair as the dining room proudly presents. Your dinner. Be
our guest. Be our guest. Put our service to the test. Tie your napkin around your neck, shall we? And with the bad zealot, soup du jour, hot or dev, why, we only live to serve. Try the grey stuff.
It's delicious.
You don't believe me? Ask the dishes. They can sing, they can dance. After all, miss, this is France. And a dinner here is never second best. Go on, fold your menu, take one glance and then you'll be our guest, we are guests, be our guest. A beef wagyu, cheese souffle, pie and pudding on a flambé. We're prepared to serve with flair and culinary cabaret. You're alive and you're scared, but the banquet's all prepared. No one's blew me up complaining while the flatware's entertaining.
We touch your
bloody tricks with my fellow candlesticks.
And it's all in perfect taste that you can bet.
Go on and lift your glass, you won your own three pots. To be our guest, if you're stressed, it's fine dining we suggest. Be our guest, be our guest, be our guest.
It's a treat for any diner, don't believe me, ask the china.
Singing pork, a dancing veal, what an entertaining meal.
How could anyone be gloomy or depressed?
We'll make you shout,
on the door, and send us out for more. So be our guest,
be our guest,
be our guest.
Whoops, it is.
What the heck?
And now, for your continued